The next paper will be presented by Dr. Afaf Ahmed on FOSS for the teaching of Fortran programming language course.
Yes, this is. So we can choose it here, right, with the enter.
Assalamu alaikum. So here I am going to present, although I am nowhere in the FOSS, I am not knowing about whatever I have learned that I want to convey to you. What is the effort in the department? How we are benefiting it without thinking about what is FOSS? We are unaware of it. So see that how I will justify, just I am going to give, the authors' names are here. So what I am going to talk about is FOSS, what it is, some examples, Linux for the human being, distribution and adoption, FOSS in education, and at SQU how many tools, it is not a FOSS, but I can say that is a tools which we have, teaching Fortran with a GFortran compiler and a Gini editor, that is a FOSS, and the features, the support files, operating system environments, which is supported by the Gini, and available code versions, and in the last, if you want, we can discuss, and I will present the conclusion. So look here, as everybody knows, and now you are aware, since this is the second conference, that is a man, Richard, in 1983, has put forward an idea while the Unix was in the Thank you. So, but it is clear to me that is maybe G for Germany, but I don't know. It is still not clear. But this is clear here that is no Unix. All right. You can run your system, and that was the age of the Unix, and C programming has developed. But here you are having some advantages that is use, study, change, improve. Yes, you are knowing that is a FOSS is a free, but you have to take attention of this, that is installation and maintenance service by technicians can be charged. So don't think that is the nucleus is no problem. It's still the same faith which he started in 1983. Then in 1985, non-profitable organization has come. They have built it. So this you have to keep in mind, it is not fully free. And these are the some examples. And these are the, you can say, what are the open source and what are the closed source. Now the popular distributors. And when you are talking about the Linux, it comes to my mind that is, as we are talking about the human right, and similarly, Linux has done a lot. You can say it, that is, having the distributor did a lot here. Okay, sorry, just we'll go through it. Yes, so I will not be away, huh? Before this, yes. Yes, it is all right.
So this is your, this one, away.
And the next.
Okay, inshallah.
So now look here, if you look here, what I am saying, that is, if you are one way talking in the world, that is, the, what is a human right, if you are going to talk about, you can say that is, the governments must take care of, that is, the first thing is the food. The second thing, that is, you can debate about, that is, the either the health or the shelter. But the third thing is nothing but the education. So if you look here, that is, many governments, many things, you can just read over there and find. But what I'm highlighting, that is, I am too fast. What I want to highlight here, that is, if you look the FAS in India, they have opened almost in 2008. And one of the great achievement, if you are going to look over there, that is a three, that is, they have distributed the only charging the $35, and they have given the tablet to the students. And how it was possible, just because of the FAS. And there are many things you will find over there. It is already, it is written there. Now I'm coming to the point that is a right away. What is our duty? What is our responsibility, being a teacher? Now look here, when you are coming in the FAS, and I am talking about the FAS in education, before that, I want to just quote, because I cannot, only the translation is here, some verses from religious books. If I can say about, just listen it very carefully, then the purpose of the FAS and whatever our responsibility, it will be clear to us. It says here exactly the translation, if anyone going on his way in search of knowledge, God thereby make easy for him the way to paradise. The another without quoting, that is from where, read, seek, educate yourself, be educated. Then if I am coming to the another, are those equal? Those who know and those who do not know. Now the debate is here. Those who know, those who do not know. Whose responsibility is those who do not know? Then I am coming here. That is, look here, if you are going to look, there are two things, no botheration, no fight, nothing, no debate. Divide the education in two parts. One is a religious education and another is a secular education. Religious education is what you are getting the guidelines of your religion, how to do this. But when you are coming to the secular, what you are having means how you are going to deal with your day-to-day life. And when you are coming to talk about day-to-day life, everything is clear, what is our responsibility? So look here, what I am writing it here, that is, I am saying that is, a FAS can reduce the cost of education sectors such as primary and secondary. Then FAS will help increasing the quality of teaching and learning through the affordable, virus-free, reliable computers. With efficient access to information from internet, students can work better in their assignments, reports, and projects. With the reduction in software cost, internet access can become more affordable. If university use FAS as the main solutions in delivering their programs, millions of dollars can be saved through the software, not using those licensed software. And this can enable universities to lower their fees, which are currently not affordable by the common people of the world. And here I can again, if you look whether the government is giving the subsidy to their people, but education, if you are going to calculate, nobody can deny about it, the education is varying from $6,000 to the $50,000 per semester. This is the cost of education today. And how we are going to keep this, that is a big problem. Now look here at our part, I am not saying just to make aware of it, that is, the teachers can do many things. Means, for example, universal product code, how many of us? We are having the library's ISBN number, how to change it to the 13 or the 10, how to correct it? No, only we are using it. Then similarly, the barcodes, we are not knowing about it, but these are the small programs. Only I will highlight here that is how we saved our two of the one course, that is a digital logic design. Completely we switched to the Logisim program, which is a free. And since 3 years, we are running that, and the students are enjoying, and we are also, means you can say, feeling that is we are giving something to the student. Otherwise, all the time, that is, I don't have a license, how I can copy it here, this or that. Now I'm coming to this. That is, this is the course which I think the required course for the College of Science, maybe the, I think the stat students, they are taking mathematics. But we are teaching this course, so about 5 years before, we were facing a problem and we searched and we got over there and we are using this free open source and we are enjoying. And I am going to just, and I am not debating, although in the paper you will find over there, that is, can the Fortran revert back? That is a big question, but I am not debating to that. In some cases, it is in optimization, particularly it is more than the C++. And look here, that is, these files are supported by this, what we are using. Almost every program, everything is there. And if you are coming to this, that is, what are these operating systems? So well supported here. And they have the versions here that we can take it. And now in the conclusion, I can say only, that is, see here, programming languages are always debatable. The person who did the work in Fortran want to keep himself only in Fortran, don't want to change. Somebody who doesn't know the C, knowing the Java, he will or she will just talk about that. But in my opinion, what I searched over there with the American universities, Australian, Canadian, I involved one of the students from the university, and we got over there, that is, we can say, that is, our proposal is, that is, the student, no doubt, now the community is C. Means in the world, the community is C-based. But what we are looking over there, that is, if you teach the Fortran to your students in the beginning, also don't leave. That is, a MATLAB is a thing. We are some of the courses, or we are not just teaching as a language over there. So in our opinion, we are saying it here, we authors think that it is reasonable that a student must learn C++ before they graduate. Though when more important is that they learn how program MATLAB, means they must know. There is an existence of the MATLAB, how they can use it. However, the issue is what freshmen should learn as their first language, and for that, we would like to recommend Fortran. We will only recommending this, and this is because this is a better language for scientific programming, and both easier and learn and use than the alternatives. So thank you very much. If you have anything, just you can talk to me, no problem, if the time is there. Okay, thank you.